My friends, welcome back to the show. I'm really glad that you're tuning in because today we have yet another exciting and a very interesting episode. Today, we're going back to ancient history and looking at one of history's biggest empires once again. This time, we're talking about the Achaemenid Empire, also known as the Persian Empire. And for the rest of this video, I'm going to call it the Persian Empire because it's so much easier to pronounce. Known for being the empire that built roads, infrastructure, a postal system, an official language, and even freed the Jews from the Babylonian exile, you can be sure that the Persian Empire is going to be a very interesting episode. If you're new here, I'm Darius Cause, and this is Vlogs of Knowledge, and it's absolutely awesome every single week. If you're not subscribed, I really think that you should be because you are missing out. Every single week we have a brand new episode about history, and it's absolutely awesome. So make sure to subscribe, make sure to hit the notification bell, join Team Knowledge, and be notified whenever I release a new video. And with that being said, well, let's get to it. The Persian Empire was really something, like it was the biggest empire for its time, and it became an example for future empires. It demonstrated how to have proper organization, how to properly manage your people and your armies, and how to unify different cultures as a strength and not as a weakness. The Persian Empire started in 6th century BC, and around this time, the main players in the world, to name a few, were the Babylonians, the Egyptians, the Greeks, and the soon-to-be Persians. The Jews had been exiled to Babylon, and civilization had really only just begun. The empire's roots begin when Cyrus II, a member of the Achaemenid clan, is officially chosen as its leader. He was part of a few Persian tribes that lived in the Persian territory ruled by a different group of people. Cyrus wasn't really too happy with his role, so he took it upon himself to do something about it. He unified the Persian tribes together, he amassed a massive army, and revolted against the current rulers of the land. He won the battles, took the title of Shah, which translates to the King of Persia, and went on to build a capital on the site of his victory. The only problem with this sudden Persian takeover was the fact that two other provinces had agreements with the previous rulers, and neither province was really happy about a Persian takeover. One of those provinces was Babylonia itself, the huge city of Babylon, so you can obviously imagine that something had to be done with the situation. I mean, you can't really take over a territory and expect everybody else to play along and to be nice. You're going to have to deal with the problems that you create. You're going to piss some people off. Cyrus dealt with Babylon not by besieging the city, since at the time Babylon was one of the biggest and most influential cities, but by using propaganda. He basically took advantage of the fact that the current Babylonian king wasn't so popular with the Babylonian people. Instead of fighting a war that could cost him many casualties, he turned the Babylonian people against their king. When Cyrus eventually came to Babylon, he was welcomed with applauses, palm leaves, and an overwhelming support. He then declared himself the ruler of Babylon and proclaimed that he was sent by the Babylonian gods themselves to rule over the land. Cyrus established a contract with his people. He demanded they pay him a tribute for being part of his empire, and in return he'd give them protection and even the freedom to have their own customs and believe in their own gods. He freed the Jews, which at the time were exiled from Jerusalem to Babylon, and cemented for himself a high status among the Jews. I mean, if you look at the Old Testament, Cyrus is seen as a great man, which obviously makes sense. If you free your people, well, they're going to glorify you, no doubt. Unfortunately, as I always say on this show, nothing lasts forever. Cyrus was eventually going to die, and he left the throne to a supposedly distant relative called Darius I. And by the way, for those that don't know, my name is also Darius, and I hope to one day be as good and achieve as many things as Darius I did, because as you're gonna see, Darius I was really a great emperor. With revolts breaking out in Egypt, which had just been acquired during this change of emperors, Darius realized that he had to re-establish the conquest that Cyrus had made just a few decades prior. However, Darius was lucky. He had a massive army at his disposal, an army that had been growing for decades during Cyrus's rule. With this powerful army, he began to re-establish the Persian Empire and was on the verge of creating the biggest empire the world had ever seen. Darius saw diversity as a strength and not as a weakness. He installed an official language throughout the empire and brought an administration system to properly organize everything. He created provinces, each ruled by satraps, think of something like a governor, that had to report directly to the king. Each province had to pay a tribute to the king, sort of like a tax, if it wanted to be a part of the empire. This tax was organized and collected through a very extensive road system and the very first postal system ever. Darius literally had messengers stationed all throughout the empire, which made communication very fast and very efficient. Now, to prevent any satrap from being greedy and taking all the power or the money for themselves, he created a military position that was there to only supervise everything the satrap did and report directly back to the king. And this was very effective. It's kind of hard to steal or fraud the king if somebody is watching your every move and has a direct line of communication to the king himself. Like I personally, I wouldn't do it. Now just think about it. This was the 6th century BC. They had roads, they had infrastructure, they had administration, they were organized, and they had a postal system. Like this was amazing for its time. And that's what I meant when I said that the Persian Empire was going to become an example for future empires to come. I mean, the Persian Empire had so many good things that future empires had no choice but to follow. Like, this was the reason why the Persian Empire got so big. And by the way, this was only possible by a man whose first name happens to be Darius. Just saying. Darius used the tax money to build many great things for the Persian people. He built irrigation systems, roads, funded mining explorations, and he created a common currency that could be used all throughout the empire. He brought architects and builders from around the world to build a new Persian capital, Persepolis, and it was beautiful. Darius was truly a great ruler, and under his rule, the Persian Empire reached its biggest extent. Although he never acknowledged Cyrus and his accomplishments, perhaps this is due to the fact that Darius probably wasn't related to Cyrus, and that he only claimed to be. Like, historians are still unsure, but it looks like he probably wasn't. Darius wanted to become better than Cyrus, and as he was accomplishing more and more things, he eventually reached his goal. He was the greatest emperor the empire had ever seen. He dropped the title of Shah, which remember meant king, and adopted the new title of Shahanshah, which meant the King of Kings, a title that was to become synonymous with the Persian Empire. So much so that Alexander the great general, would even seek to have that title when he eventually conquered Persia. Unfortunately, once again, nothing lasts forever. Revolts started breaking out in Greece, and Darius tried to calm them down by teaching Greece a lesson, which literally meant getting an army, going to war, and trying to take them over. Unfortunately, he failed. Humiliated, he goes back to Persia, raises taxes, and tries to attack Greece once again, but unfortunately never lives to see that fight happen. He dies of old age, and the empire is then passed on to his son, Xerxes. Now, Xerxes had a lot more problems to deal with. The raised taxes started even more revolts in the empire, and when he finally attacked Greece for the second time, well, he failed as well. He then resolved to have a private life in the comfort of his luxury as king, a lifestyle that future kings would soon follow. No longer were they to be publicly seen all the time. They were to live a quiet life at home, away from the public. The empire was starting to fall apart. The empire that Cyrus and Darius had built was strong enough to resist this slide into decadence for about 200 years, but gradually, it took its toll. Some satraps created their own islands of power, and inflation began to spike as taxes kept on rising. Even the multiculturalism of the empire, which was initially its biggest strength, was starting to fall apart. Eventually, as the empire grew weaker, it became the perfect target for a new young general that was entering the scene of history, Alexander the Great. And that, my friends, is unfortunately the end of the Persian Empire. I really hope that you've enjoyed this brief history lesson on the Persian Empire. If you did, please leave it a big thumbs up, make sure to subscribe, make sure to hit the notification bell, join Team Knowledge, and be notified whenever I release a new video. And now it's time for questions. Have you heard about the Persian Empire before? Did you learn anything new from this video? And who was your favorite emperor? Was it Cyrus, was it Darius, or was it Xerxes? Please do leave me a comment, I would love to read and answer them all. And yes, I do answer all of your comments. And bonus points for you, if you do leave a comment, you might get featured in next week's video as the final of the week. And now just a little disclaimer, I know I haven't talked about everything regarding the Persian Empire, that's okay. I'm actually doing this on purpose because I want to give you guys enough information to get you curious, to get you interested, so that you can go out on your own, research and learn a thing or two. And in fact, if you do want to research, there's some links in the description that I've put conveniently for you where you can start. I would strongly encourage you because this is a subject that has a lot of information and really it's very interesting. And with that being said, my name has been Darius Kazan, it's been an absolute pleasure, thank you for watching and I will see you all next week.